you know, if you see a truck training program for $999, that's a licensing mill. Or $650, that's a licensing mill.
Or like I seen on Saturday when I was going to work in Toronto, a little sandwich board or sign stuck in the grass that said, guaranteed jobs, shifting 350, air brake endorsement 150. And then when you follow up, you find out that they even claim to be registered with the Ministry of Training, Colleges and Universities, which are not.
There are these low-end cut-rate schools that are ripping off students and putting bad drivers on the road.
Any course that costs under $1,000 is exempt from ministry oversight. So what a lot of these cut-rate schools in the GTA do is they offer driving courses for, say, $999 to avoid provincial oversight.
And so that's, so with the air brake and the, like, what would the full cost be?
This one is including the air brake.
Okay.
But here you have to pay $200 extra for the $999.
Okay, so that would be like $1,200.
Yeah.
They'll get you in the door for $1,000, but it ends up you pay more for this little bit of extra course here. Maybe you failed this part of the course and you have to do it again. So they're actually charging you more but not being caught because there's no real oversight of what they're doing.
Another aspect of our story is looking at how people who want to become tractor-trailer drivers actually get tested.
The most surprising thing that I found was that tractor-trailers, which are at least 40 times heavier than the average passenger car, some of these drivers are not being tested on a major highway, which is a big part of their job. I was stunned.
So we spent several weeks staking out the Woodbridge Commercial Truck Testing Center here in the GTA, and we observed more than a dozen tests, road tests that is, in which tractor-trailer drivers were not taken on any 400 series highway or any road over 80 kilometers an hour speed limit at all. This is despite the fact that truck drivers spend a significant amount of their time on highways.
So they train specifically to pass the test. They do their two left turns and their two right turns and exactly what they need on the pre-trip inspection and the air brake, and that's all they teach for the 12 hours. So great, we now have a licensed driver who has passed a road test because that's all they were trained for, but they can't do anything else.
So the average amount of time spent actually testing these people on the road was about 15 minutes.
But you can't see whether a person is a good driver in 15 minutes.
Okay, that's good right there.
So Kim Richardson and his son Matt run a school in Caledonia that specializes in upgrading skills for people who have obtained their AZ license. So they're allowed to, under the law, drive a tractor trailer with air brakes, but who are unable to get jobs because they simply don't have the skills to become a professional.
So tighter over. Beauty. That's how you do it.
We absolutely do retraining. We get drivers who have been licensed from these licensing mills and received inadequate training, and they go to try to get a job at a reputable carrier. You know, some of the carriers that are brand name, and those carriers won't hire these individuals because they don't meet their standards.
Ultimately, it's up to the Ministry of Transportation, the provincial government, to implement rules and standards.
They need to sink teeth into their regulations. They need to shut schools down. They need to take action. They need to enforce. It's great to have regulation, but regulation without enforcement, it goes nowhere.
I think the public should take a very keen interest on who they're sharing the road with, because trucks are sharing their workspace with you, and that happens to be our roads and our highways. And if you're part of the motoring public, I think you would hope the person beside you in the tractor trailer knows what he or she is doing.